Welcome to the first chapter of Food 101, Fermentation and the Microbrewery. I'm your engineer Riley, and today, Bunny and I are going to teach you how to make a brewery right here in your own kitchen. You'll need to watch this tutorial before you're ready to make my recipes for mead, apple cider, and wine. As a friendly reminder, these videos are for viewers 21 and over. But if you're looking for alcohol-free and kid-friendly recipes, check out my videos on homebrew sodas. Let's get to it!
All you need is silicone, tubing, a mason jar, and a drill. The first step is to drill a hole in the top of the lid. One of the byproducts of fermentation is carbon dioxide gas, which will cause pressure to build up in the jar. This pressure needs to be released or the bottle will explode. Next, I'm going to attach the tubing through the lid. The tubing should be long enough that it will reach into another jar. It only needs to be about half an inch or so on the inside of our fermenting jar. I'm going to seal both sides of the lid around the tubing. It's really important to get a good seal on both sides of the lid because we do not want air to leak into the jar. And if moisture builds up around the tubing, it could cause rust or a buildup of bacteria. The other end of the tubing will be submerged in water to ensure the air can't travel back through the tube. As your fermentation action begins, you should start to see bubbles in the jar of water. That is how you know it's working. Good luck constructing, and let me know in the comments below if you need any help.